Okay, sorry I'm running a few minutes behind today. We're getting there. I had to get food sorted, and then the husband and I got into a debate about something, and then I kind of got distracted by something else, and then I'm like sitting here having an internal debate further, and I'm like, happened to just glance at the time, and I'm like, oh shit! So. I got distracted. Sorry. I probably would have still been a few minutes late anyway, but. We're here. We're getting our shit together. Kinda. I like this one, but it's also driving me crazy that the black fluff is like picking up every little bit of other fluff. Probably because we're surface stabbing, so it's a little bit fuzzier. So it's like picking up every other bit of fluffy stuff. And I'm just like, why? Oh, I was working on something else last night. So I got the speed felt finished for the sixth tutorial that we followed. Yay! So that went up last night, and then I was like, okay, well, I need to download the stuff for 7. So I started doing that, and while that was going on, I was working on another project. I didn't get it finished, but yeah, it's not looking half bad. It's gonna be like a little beach thing, and this top piece is gonna end up getting folded over the hanger piece. So yeah, it's not bad. We'll see how that goes. All right, let's get our needle sorted here. So, in the chat, you'll find the link to the tutorial. Thank you, Mubot. So, if you want to watch the tutorial in full, you can go to can go to that over there. That's going to take you to the Bob Ross YouTube channel. There we go. Where you can find that. It's from, we're working on Season 3, Episode 8, Night Light. And in fact, today we will be starting to work on the Night Light. So we're gonna get our red out. Fuzz in the mouth, that's not good. That's a large chunk of red. I don't want that much out right now. I'm not saying we won't need that much, but I just don't want that much out floating about at this very moment. All right. So again, sorry I'm running a little bit late today. So how is everybody? How has your weekend been going? Going relatively well, I hope. All right, yeah, I want to work in much smaller chunks, so. Let's get to stabbing here, I guess. Seeing what we can do here. Just want to be real particular about that edge there. And at the moment, we are using acrylic yarn. Traditionally, you use roving. Or like wool of some description, but it can be done with this. It might take a little bit longer. Just because it doesn't like instantly stick to itself, kind of like the wool roving does, but it'll work. It is possible. We've proven that so far. So I do have the tutorial up in the corner. That's just to kind of bottom corner, just to give us a idea of what we are working towards at the moment. And then up in the upper left hand corner, we've got the kind of test run that we did with a test run concept idea, however you want to refer to it as, that we did with the colored pencil, just to kind of work the idea out in our head. Okay. So we are going to take this out a little bit into the darkness here. Not tremendously, but a little bit. Doesn't need to be too crazy. It is actually not 900 degrees in here today, and it is wonderful. It's actually chilly in here yesterday. We had some more thunderstorms and more move through early this morning. Didn't really care for those all that much. They were a little loud and cranky. I I could have done without those. I'm gonna be completely honest. Like, those, yeah, no. Wasn't a fan of those. Alright, so we've got a lot of loose, little end bits here. I'm just trying to make sure that we've got all those guys settled in there. So if you are doing this as well, you know, do what you want to do. You don't even have to do this as needle felting if you're following along with your medium of choice. You'll probably be done a lot faster than me, which is awesome. I'd love to see what you're doing, how you're doing it. That would be really kind of cool. Sorry, an idea just popped into my head and I'm like, that would be baller. So, and then I'm like, suddenly went off in a direction of, how would I make that work? Kind of rein myself back in for right now. That was. Alright, so we do have a little bit of a, it's not a gap, it's more like a seam, I guess, I tried to show up there. I can probably deal with that with the next color coming in. That shouldn't be too much trouble. So this feels like paint box. Lost the piece, I'm like, wait, doesn't feel like there's anything in my hands. It's because there's not. What are you, and where did you come from? Get out of there. But paint box has a distinctive feel to it. At least the paint box chunky. So we don't have to follow our pen line here to the T. We can go a little bit outside of it. That's fine. I mean, who's gonna know once we get the stuff in? Or the other one's gonna know that we didn't follow it directly. It's just kind of to keep me on track. Because sometimes we can get carried away, so that's why I like to sketch my stuff in. So we'll get this worked in around the edges. But like, we don't want to be too skimpy with it either. So we want it to overlap the black a bit here. But like a piece like this size might be a little big in here, maybe. I don't know. We'll see. So I had been so focused on trying to do that surface stabbing thing, because I had seen somebody else do theirs, and I was like, oh, am I stabbing too deep? And so when we got this mat, I was trying to do that surface stabbing thing, and it felt like it was slowing me down a little bit, but I wasn't getting the weird like separations and stuff. But then, on the other piece I was doing, I noticed I stopped concentrating about trying to do the surface stabbing, and I think it was stabbing a little bit more into the felt, or into the mat, and I noticed it still wasn't really doing the weird separation thing, so I was like, oh. Maybe it was the mat, because I haven't really had too many issues. It's definitely been more fuzzy instead of carpety. Because some of the other ones we did, they definitely looked carpety. I mean, there's no real question about that. Okay, so there we started stabbing a little bit deeper, so you can see that it went in a little bit deeper. You could hear it pull up. So I don't know. We'll see how things continue. And how they go. And there's going to be two more colors that are going to be coming in to this, don't forget. So we are trying to layer these guys up here. Uh, At least a little bit. Okay. Hitting this guy. Again, I want to make sure I get these little end guys good and anchored, because they're just kind of out here all willy-nilly. Okay, if you see me rubbing my finger against part of it, I'm just trying to see if I see any fiber move in a way that I didn't want it to be moving, because I mean, sometimes you'll get a little bit of, there'll be a little bit of softness, but if it moves a little too much under your fingers, then you know you've got some stuff that's not quite completely anchored down. And that's probably more of like a stylistic choice if you want it to be a little bit loose, because I mean, after it's done, you really wouldn't be touching it all that much. Like, not really. It would probably be weird. Right. So we'll work on getting this guy put in. Now, I'm kind of okay with the ends being like willy-nilly and wild and stuff, because it's kind of like the light reflecting off the clouds here that we can't see. And so that's okay. I kind of want them to be doing their own thing out here. Let's see. But that does mean that the ends take a little bit more fussin' when they're tiny. At least in this stuff. To get them to where I'm happy with their anchorage level. Okay, I have to be a little bit more reserved as we get to the top here. I didn't leave myself a whole lot of room to work with up here. And I can come into this band here, that's not that big of a deal, because the orange is where this is gonna, orange is gonna live in here, right? So it really wouldn't be that bad. Just be a little bit more overlapping. So this color is not like a red red. What is this color anyway? This is a red wine, so it's a little bit more muted. It's not like a bright cardinal red. It's more of a dulled down red. I mean, in some respects, it's a little bit lighter than like a cardinal red, but kinda lighter but dull. I don't. That probably doesn't make sense to some people, but I mean, it's fairly red on the camera. But it's certainly not like fire engine red. I only have two shades of red that's not roving, and yeah, we could have gone with roving. We could have. But I wanted to make sure I had enough. But basically, just, you know, whatever rev you have. That you are comfortable using. Then use that. That might not look quite how we are going for here. It might be a little too polished on the edge there. I'm gonna turn this guy just so we can get a little more, not really texture, but bit more wildness to it. So if we do what I was originally going to do there, it would have been pretty straight and cut off, and that's fine if that's what you're going for. But since I've got the rest of this kind of all wild and free, we should probably keep going with that as best as we can. Now, it doesn't say anywhere that you're not allowed to cut your fluff to the size that you need, so by all means, if you need to trim your fluff, trim your fluff. Yeah, these guys are definitely all over the place here. That's okay. Because in the end, it will give us that look that we are going for. Unless we attach to the mat. Okay, so yeah, we got a little too stabby there. We got a little too deep there. That didn't want to let go of the mat. In that particular spot. Okay. So I've got it turned this way so I can see what we're doing. A little bit easier for me. So this red is going to come down into our into all of our color areas, actually, just for his bit of his anchor point there. That's okay. this very moment, I do wish I'd given myself a little bit more room here at the top. But that's neither here nor there right now. Just kind of have to work with it at this point. Kind of one of those, well, live and learn moments. I mean, we could have tried to squish everything down a little bit lower. So yeah, if we go too deep, if we don't just surface stab, then we start depositing fluff into the mat. So you can see a little bit of red coming in here, but it's not too bad, right? Like, we can still work with that. We're not attached to the mat. I'm sure if we kept going, we would be attached to the mat. Okay, this is where things start to get a little bit tricky, because we're getting smaller. Let's not turn that towards my face. Like, let's not do that. So yeah, tonight I'm probably gonna take off from trying to edit to work on my other piece, because I don't have that much time tonight. Because after dinner, we have to do, or we're supposed to do, some kind of board game with my mom. And there was something else we were gonna do. I thought maybe. Maybe not. That actually looks like I've got a little bit of the bottom fluff kind of poking through there, like the base color. So I might just have to make sure that we add a bit of our orange in there to overlap to take care of that. I mean, we could go back and add a bit more red, but we're already kind of infringing in the orange section anyway. So I think we'll just leave that up to orange itself. So how's everybody's weekend going? Everybody doing good? Did you work? How was it? What did you get up to? I'm just trying to get this bit of fluff here. Oh, that was my hand. Okay. That was a cracky, crunchy noise. Clicky noise, didn't like that. Bones, you're not supposed to make those noises, stop it. Especially that one, I need that one. I've tried doing this left-handed. It ain't pretty. It is really not. I've tried. Me doing anything with my left hand is not pretty. I don't know if it's just a case of because this one's had how many years of practice? Like 40 plus. But, yeah, I've tried to write with my left hand. I've tried to do all the things. I think the only thing I could probably do with my left hand, where it's still gonna look like a hot mess. I mean, my left hand can hold things sometimes. Sometimes my left hand can pour things. Sometimes. But finger painting would probably be the only thing I could really get away with my left hand. It's still gonna look like probably worse than a preschooler doing it. I mean, with a preschooler, you'd probably be at least have some idea of what the hell they were doing. Okay, we're getting there on the red. And blue definitely took us a little bit less time, I think. But we didn't have to be quite so particular on blue's top edge. I mean, that is, you know, it is what it is for that. Let go, please. Thank you. Okay. So I need to kind of start angling this stuff in this direction. So we're kind of working our way around here. Now I'm not real worried about this inner edge area at the moment. I mean, I'm a little worried about it, but not as much as you'd think. I'm more thinking of, okay, I need to cover that. Kind of worry and not like, oh, it's all over the place kind of worry, you know? It's sort of a different keep an eye on it approach. Because there's going to be other colors coming in on top of it, so just trying to be like, okay, well, I need to overlap this here. Not as attached as I thought it was. Surprise. So far, I'm really liking this particular episode that we're following. Hey, Zortz, how goes it? How are you today? Hopefully you're doing all right. Okay, so then we just need to start putting in around in here. Not too bad. I actually don't have mandated overtime for Monday or Tuesday. Nice. That's always a plus. Always, always. It's actually below 90 at the moment. It's so exciting. My legs were so cold when I went to bed last night. I was freezing. I had the, like, all of the blankets. Not like winter blankets, but after days of, you know, a sheet touching me wanting to burst into flames, it was nice. We had some rain that we needed really bad. I think we're all done with the rain for today now. It's not supposed to rain tomorrow, but it's supposed to rain on my birthday, so I was like, ah, fucking hell. It says morning thunderstorms. It says AM thunderstorms. I don't know what that means. That could be after midnight. That could be at like 10 o'clock in the morning. I don't know what that means. That could mean a lot of things. So we'll see. But yay, no mandated overtime. You get a moment to, you know, get shit done that hasn't been getting done. Or just not move, I mean. I would probably have to do a combination of the two, but probably not moving for a little while would probably be high on the list. Keep on. I don't know. Is that too big? I don't know. Kind of feels like it might be a little overkill there. That probably could have been a little bit smaller, but we'll see. Yeah, so I need to work on my other needle felted project. That I'll probably only end up paying myself like 15 cents an hour for by the time I'm done. But that's okay, because I had another idea. To work on. That one's gonna be a little more involved, though, I think. And I have to figure out what type of sealer I want to get. I've been playing around with brush on sealer. Don't really like the brush strokes the one is leaving behind. And it feels tacky to me even after it's dry, and I don't like that. I have my trusty Mod Podge. I like the way that feels when it's dry. But like the least little tiny bit of humidity, or if you accidentally flick a tiny speck of water on it, it can kind of turn milky on you, and I'm like, oh, that's not gonna work. So I need to get a spray sealer, I think. But do I want gloss? Do I want matte? Do I want semi-gloss? I mean, semi-gloss might be a better option because it's kind of in between the two. I don't know. Gotta think about it. Most definitely. So what are you up to today? Do you actually have to work today? Yeah. Did you get any of that wild weather? Like, I'll get notifications of, like, certain warnings and stuff on Twitter, and I'm like, what the fuck are you talking about? What's going on here? And I go to look at the weather map, and I'm like, oh, that's a thing. I was like, that's kind of odd. Heavy rainstorm last night? Oh, okay. Yeah, I was getting nervous last night because they had said that we could have had thunderstorms for us like around 5 or 6 a.m. And I was like, okay. And then I like looked at the weather map because I'm like, okay, well, what direction are they coming from? Where are they coming from? And I'm sitting here and I'm looking at the storms in Kansas and they were kind of drifting down towards us. And I'm like, okay, that's probably where they're coming from. They're probably not coming directly from Oklahoma. They're probably coming from there and then drift over the corner and then come down to us. I'm like, okay. Fine, whatever. And then I was bored, so I was back a while later looking at the cameras and I was like, oh, hey, there's a thunderstorm rolling through here. Let's go check it out on this particular webcam that I know exists for that area from a train crossing, and I was like, okay, cool. So I'm over there and it's like midnight, right? And there's people in the chat and they're talking. It's like the more people that filter into a train camera at that time of night when it's raining, you know it's about to storm. So they get all the weather people over there. And all of a sudden, I see somebody type, oh, wow, I just got a wind warning for 80-mile-an-hour winds. I was like, what? So I knew these storms were going to be a problem for me later. And I quick reopened the weather maps, and I'm like, oh, dear. Oh, dear. And I'm like, hey, Russell, before you go to bed. He's like, what? I was like, can you get the recycling buckets and stack them on the porch? Because I don't know if we're going to get a piece of this. But, you know, we did have we're leaving deposits of red all over, probably because I'm stabbing a bit deeper. Sometimes we do get a piece of it, and there was a wind warning a while ago for like 100-mile-an-hour winds coming out of Tulsa, and I was like, yeah, no, what we're not gonna do is fuck with that. So, so he went and stacked everything. We did get the thunderstorm, because I'm like, watch, I'm gonna ask him to stack them up and put them on the porch, and then it's not gonna storm. But no, we did get some storms. We got, like, house-shaking thunder at, like, 5 o'clock this morning as I'm trying to fall asleep. And I'm like, oh, really? I don't like this. And I was laying there, and I heard a noise. And I was like, what the fuck? And I thought it was, like, somebody's car stereo. But then I'm sitting there thinking, I'm like, but wait, did a car go by? And while I'm sitting there trying to contemplate it, and I started to just kind of write it off as, you know, it must have been a car. Then I heard it again. Because when I checked the radar, there was no storms over us. they were getting closer, but they weren't over us. I didn't think they were in hearing range yet. And it was eerie. You could hear the storm approaching. Like, every time it thundered, it was closer. And I was like, okay. And one bout of thunder went on for almost 15 seconds. I don't think it really lasted that long. I think it was the echo off the mountains around us that was making it seem that long. But it just seemed to roll. And I'm like, oh my god, why isn't it stopping? It's like, what is happening? And like, I went back and I reloaded the radar on my Kindle. And I'm like, I don't see anything I need to be inherently concerned about. But this is weird. This is very weird. And then all of a sudden there was this round of thunder that you could hear the walls vibrate. It was like a thud thud vibration. And then I was like, all right, let's have enough of that. And then as I'm thinking that, then the bed vibrated and moved, and because we have like a foam mattress, so I can feel like everything through the floor. And I was like, oh god. And then you could hear the floor vibrate, and I was like, oh, for fuck's sake, what is happening? And I'm like, Russell had to have woken up from that, because it like almost sounded like somebody dropped like a bowling ball. But I guess those are better than the ones that sound like a gunshot going off in your ear. Those I really don't like. I'm like, we've had a few of those where I like jump 5 feet in the air. I'm like, okay, let's not do that again. But, I was actually expecting Russell to come out of the bedroom on the whole house shaking one. I'm like, that had to have woken him up. It had to have. And, come to find out this morning, he's like, something did wake me up. I'm like, well, it stormed. He goes, oh, that must have been what it was. I was like, I figured you'd be out. And he's like, no. He must have fell right back asleep. Because it went on for a little while, and then it kind of stopped, and then it started again, and I was like, must we? But it just kept going and going and going. Where have you been?
Hopped in the shower. Tried to eat some of my waffles. I may not be able to eat them myself. When they cooked, they smelled really badly burnt.
Mine didn't smell like that. It was just the texture I couldn't do.
Mine burnt, though. So, like, I'm not sure exactly what I'm going to do. I guess I'll figure it out.
I was wondering where you had vanished to. I was about to come hunt you down, make sure you were okay. Alright, so we're almost done with the red here for right now. We're not completely done with the red, because we're going to have more red down in here. But we're not too there yet, so don't want to jump the gun too much. I do have to get cracking on that other video edit. I want a couple days of not doing editing. Because that last one, man. I don't know why that last one was such a fucking bitch. But it just seemed to never end. I guess because of how I was doing the ground. Where I was doing a base color and then coming back in with a top color. Maybe that's what felt like it added. I mean, I know there was added time on there because that one was like 17 live streams instead of like the 13 that the last project was. So, I mean, that was kind of wild that it added that much time to it. But then again, the last one was a lot simpler. I think. And that was like 13 live streams with the addition of showing the finishing. Like doing the bars on it and stuff. You're being weird over here on this side. I mean, like bunchy. Is that because we left the middle pieces here? Could be. Okay. We'll start to get this guy anchored in. So I know this looks like a hot mess on the inner. Oh, that's why we wear the finger thingies. I know it looks like a hot mess on the inner circle. And it is. I'm not gonna argue that. But it doesn't matter right now. This can be a hot mess on this inner circle. We still have a bit to go. So if this is red, where was my orange line? I feel like, so if this was orange, so this is all yellow. I feel like we lost our red line a bit here. And we may very well have. I might have actually cut too close with the black. I just lost track of it. Get that tapped into there. still have a few loose ends over in here that I want a bit more secure. Okay. So we're gonna have to get a bit more fluff off of our bunch here. So, what's everybody's plans for the next coming week? Anything, nothing? Working, book clubs, whatever. What you doing? Last minute summer vacations? I think the last vacation we went on was when we were in Key West. That was back in 2018. Probably the only vacation that we'll have had for quite a while. Don't really have the money to go anywhere, and I don't really have a pet sitter or a parent sitter. Pet and Parent Center is out of state at the moment. Well, to be perfectly honest, that one kind of needs a parent sitter with them too. Oh, that's a thin spot trying to open up there, that is. Well, you know what we'll do with that? I was kind of curious as to whether or not that was going to happen. Since we were just doing the surface in that area. That's okay, though. We'll just kind of tuck a little bit more of our red in on top of that. I tell you, it's expensive to go on vacation anymore. Well, it's always been expensive for us, but I mean, I guess it depends on where you go. But I've even been having trouble finding hotel reservations still. Kind of feels like everybody's still in their revenge vacation mode from when everything was shut down. And by that, I mean like when stuff started opening back up, people were like, fuck this, I'm going somewhere. It still kind of feels like it's still that kind of way, because you can't seem to find hotel reservations, or at least the one place that we stayed at that I liked to stay at. The location was great. Every time I look at their website, there's nothing available. It says everything is booked. But they're still advertising on Facebook, and I'm like, is it just that you've got, like, 2 days here, 3 days there? Like, you don't have a solid week open? Is that what it is? Because I've noticed at the one property, I finally got it to show me what dates were available at least once. It's like, oh, we have a night here, we have two nights here, and I'm like, you're a vacation rental at this particular location. What the heck? Like, why are people only coming in for, like, a night and staying here? Like, one night. Go somewhere else. I want to do a week at your vacation rental because you are pet friendly. Is there not room in the bed and breakfast sister property for them, or what? But if we end up going back again, I'm gonna have to add a little bit to that side. Because looking at how everybody else is kind of like splayed out, and then there's like this guy that's all straight and narrow, doesn't quite match. We might have to stay on the newer side. I liked that place because they have parking, because not everybody does. And parking can be a little expensive down there, depending on, you know, what's going on. So we just need a little bit more. I'm gonna let the black kind of shine through right there, because we're gonna have some orange overlapping, so I'm not that worried about that particular spot. Not really. But I do want to get this section filled in here. I want to kind of get right up on the edge of that part of the lighthouse. We can get that all tacked down there, because I mean, we're gonna have some red color splaying on this, but I think I decided the base of the lighthouse is gonna be like a brownish color because it's dark. I kind of silhouetted out, but I didn't really want it to be black. Then we're gonna lose it entirely. I mean, I might put some splotches of black on it, but okay, so now to just kinda rough up our edge here just a little bit on this guy. Just a little. We don't have to go completely all over everything, but just in this spot. Probably not be a bad idea. Just so it looks a little more like everybody else. Because now that I'm looking at it, that straight edge is kind of bugging me. Alright. Is probably too big of a piece here. But that's okay. Yeah, that just looks a little bit better. Getting that edge a bit more wild. Still not sure if I made the right choice in red color. Maybe it would have been better to go with more of like the in-your-face red, but I don't know. It's also like a nighttime sky-ish thing happening here, so the other red might have been more of like a sunset red off the clouds here. It might have been a lot for nighttime. Alright, so one more little bit here, and then we can grab the orange, I think. Alright, so I'm gonna anchor this side. Uh-oh, it's a Momo. It's him, Momo. It's a doggy. Do I need to get him? Okay. I do need to do a quick pass in Planet Zoo at some point this week to get caught back up. Need to throw some building facades up. Probably take me about maybe, well, knowing me, I'm thinking it would take me like a half an hour, but realistically it'll probably take me like an hour. And then she's back to trying to getting on your keyboard. All the cats want to be on Russ's keyboard. Some ridiculous reason. Grab a bit of our orange fluff. So this is the paint box yarn again. So this is gonna kind of straddle both of these colors a bit. Or at least that's the plan. Well, I straddle both of them. I say that because there's going to be yellow going in here, but yellow is going to sit on top of the orange. And then we'll have like the silhouetted out top of the lighthouse that we haven't put in yet. That's going to sit on top of the yellow, so that's why we didn't draw that in. There really wasn't much of a point since it was going to get covered up anyway. In about here. And we'll see how this is gonna lay in here. Hopefully. Get that to lay in fairly well. Never really know how some colors are going to behave. Until you really get down in there. So this color, I kind of feel like this color should be a little more red, just based off the name. It's a little bit, I guess it's not a pumpkin orange, so I don't know, maybe the name fits. Wouldn't that be great, just to, you know, be the person that names yarn colors or paint colors all day? I shall call you this. Be a cool job. Or at least it sounds like it would be a cool job. Like, are colors of things determined by like a group of people? Do they all vote on it, or is it like one person making the decision and then somebody else like approves it? Like, how does that work? Inquiring minds want to know. I wonder if that is something you can Google. I'll have to check later. Is it like a closely guarded secret for some companies? I wonder if some companies like overly complicate it and do like test groups and like psychological testing. Be like, Yeah, what would you do if this color was called that? Just to see if they have, like, adverse reactions to the names of colors. Like, I could see some companies going that far with it. You know, overcomplicating the thing that doesn't really need to be overly complicated. Because, you know, why not overly complicate the thing? So, apparently, for my friends that still play WoW, they're changing the Authenticator app. And they're getting rid of the old authenticator thing, and the new one's gonna be baked into the battle.net app. And I knew Russell had changed my authenticator because I knew that that battery had to be about ready to give up the ghost, and I wanted to change it before the battery died because I had one of the little key fob thingies. And, he went to go change it for me while I was working on getting our pizza dough together for tonight. And I heard him yelling about something while I was in the kitchen. I'm like, I can't hear you. And next thing I know, he comes and he goes, yeah, so, you've got stuff uninstalled anyway. Yeah, we're gonna remove all of the payment information that we have stored on there, and we're just gonna take the authenticator off because the new app wants you to verify, I think, who you are by giving them a credit card number that they can, like, keep on file or something. And I understand a lot of people probably pay for their WoW subs and stuff with credit cards and everything, but I don't know, I'm not really playing anymore. I hadn't been doing the reoccurring payment in a while. I was paying with token for a while. And it just kind of felt weird that they had to have that for the authenticator. And I'm like, I guess someone thinks it will deter people from trying to, I don't know, hack accounts or somehow get around other people's authenticators. But I don't know, it just, we both just kind of looked at each other and were like, they want a what? Peabody, what are you doing? I hear crinkly crunching, and I hear you meowing. Like a shopping bag crinkling. He's in the other room. But I don't know if the crackling is coming from in here or out there. There we go. Oh wow, yeah, so we weren't doing the surface stabbing there. It's hard to do the surface stabbing. I feel like the surface stabbing was taking me more time. So you know what, we're just gonna We'll try to do it, but... That needs a little bit of a patchy patch in there. I didn't overlap that spot quite enough. But that's okay. We can fix that. That is not a big deal.
P-Butt! Maybe he's not in the other room. Because my mind was just looking at something.
I swear, that cat... He actually got himself trapped one time when he was fucking around with one of our bookcases and he knocked a whole bunch of shit over. And he somehow had himself, like, head down stuck in a pile of books or something. And we're like, dude, how did you even? We, like, heard the crash and we're like, oh, for fuck's sake. So we went to go look and we hear him meowing. And then we realized that he was stuck under something, so we, like, panicked and started digging him out frantically, and we get to him, and he's like, meow. When we pulled him out, I'm like, dude. Stop. Mr. Cat. Can we just not? That's a little better. We got that patched up there. Next little bit, we've got a few more minutes. So yeah, sorry we got a little bit of a late start today. But it started out with me just not wanting to get up. And then I was like, no, I need to drag my ass out of bed. And then we were having a Momo moment on the bed. We conned him into coming up for just a minute. He was getting pets and scratches and he was happy. Gotta make sure I'm not putting that a little too short. Which I might be in some spots. Just keep an eye on it. Also, the paint box has a little bit of like white shiny fiber mixed into it on the chunky. So sometimes I have to double check to see if I'm seeing my base color coming up through or if it's just like the little white fibers that they use to get that color mix. This
Sometimes we have to actually pause for a moment and just double check. I'd rather double check now than realize I've got a boo-boo that I need to fix later. It's a lot easier to fix it now as we're doing the thing. And I've got quite a bit of red real estate to work with here, so I could actually make these bits of orange a little bit bigger. And then we wouldn't really have to be that worried with it. Kind of thing. But yeah, I mean, we're starting to get there. So we do have to, so we're gonna have to finish doing the orange around this center bit, right? And I know right now it doesn't really look like much, but we'll get it there. Don't worry about that. You all right?
Uh-huh. Just having a moment. I'm all right.
He's been having a rough few days. I don't know if it's because we got the letter about the court date, or if it's just like a multitude of things all at once. But he's been having a really rough go of it lately. Probably fill that in with some yellow, but we could probably also just fill it in with some orange, like while we're here with it. So
okay, yeah, you gotta hop off, buddy. Edge shield back.
If it works, I don't know.
It works when it's up there mostly.
I don't know if it's going to lose its effectiveness at any point. He had to start putting tinfoil on the back of his chair, because Ed wouldn't stop getting up there. And it would be fine if he would just lay there. But he won't just lay there. He lays there and then he starts grooming himself for like 35 minutes in a stretch. And the chair is just constantly shaking and moving, and it's like, stop. Please stop. Once in a while, they'll try to jump on my chair, but I've never really tolerated them being up there because of my neck. And like, as soon as they're up there, I'm like, off now. You know, that sneeze had me coughing until like last night. That was crazy. Blowing my nose helped only marginally, and every so often I started up again. Just the way that sneeze went off, man.
like with a sneeze that ended in a cough and like the back of my throat, and I was just ugh, not fun. All right, so I think that's where we're gonna pause for today. So I know we didn't get too far today, but I also got like a 15-minute late start, so that's all right. We'll try to be on time tomorrow. I don't think I'll have to cancel tomorrow. I'm gonna try not to. Kind of depends on how the husband's feeling when he gets home. We'll see. We should be going tomorrow. If I do have to cancel, then, you know, I'll post it on Twitter, but, or I'll like pin a message in the chat that we had to cancel for the day if anybody happens to pop in. If it even shows that, if I'm not live, it might not. But, you know, I'll at least post on Twitter if the stream has to get canceled for any reason. But, yeah, so I don't think we're doing too bad. We're off to a fairly good start here. I'm happy with where we're at so far. I mean, this looks pretty good over here. And now we're just kind of working on getting our glow from our, lighthouse going, from the light being, you know, on and flashing and stuff. So, tomorrow we will pick back up with the orange. We should be able to finish the orange and hopefully start the yellow. It'd be great if we finished the yellow. It's a possibility that we might finish the yellow because the yellow area is smaller. But we'll see. That's, you know, the tentative plans for tomorrow. So, tomorrow's stream probably around 2 p.m. Central. If we can start a little bit earlier, great. Don't know if we will be able to, but we'll see. So, hope everybody has a good start to their week. Have a good night at work sorts, and until tomorrow, you guys, have a good one.